Merry Christmas, everyone, from Unity of the Blue Ridge Sunday School. I'm Reverend Gabby, and this is Reverend Barbara Ann, and we are here to give you our Christmas spectacular. Enjoy.
Okay, children, this is so much fun. I hope you and your family can share this whole thing. Reverend Gabby has created magnificent songs for all of you to sing together and watch. They're just wonderful. And I've got this beautiful story to share with you. So with the music and the story, we hope you and your family just enjoy. This is a special gift from us, from Unity of the Blue Ridge, to all of you. And the name of the story is The Mouse in the Manger. It's by Reverend Gennaro L. Gentile, and the artwork is by Vernon McKissick. I hope you enjoy the story. A long, long time ago, a family of mice lived in a burrow under a large grassy field. They lived there for many years. Their home was very large and warm and comfortable. The entrance was in the field, and when you came down the tunnel, you came to a very large room. Each member of the family had his own bedroom, and each mouse had his own straw bed. The name of the youngest mouse was Oscar. Oscar loved his family, especially all his brothers and sisters, but for him, the most special thing in the whole world was his straw bed. He used to play in the straw, crawl into it, and curl up. Covered with straw, he'd fall asleep. But Oscar wanted a bigger bed. One day, he went to his father and said, "Dad, I'm getting bigger, and I need more straw for a larger bed." His father said to him, "Oscar, I'd like to give you more straw, but we don't have any more. It's winter now, and the snow is covering the grass. You'll have to wait until spring. When it's warm again, I promise I'll get you more straw." Oscar became angry. He yelled at his father, "I want it now. I don't want to wait till springtime." His father said to him, "Enough, Oscar. I have explained it to you. Don't you yell at me. We'll get the straw when the weather is warmer. Now go to your room." Oscar was now really angry. He went to his room. He held his head in his hands and he said to himself, "I need more straw for my bed. If they really loved me, they would give me more straw. My father isn't fair in sending me to my room. I have every right to be angry. And since they don't love me, I'm not going to stay here. I'm going to run away tonight. I'll miss my brothers and sisters, but I'll go anyway." So that night, after everyone had gone to bed, Oscar very quietly tiptoed out of his room. He took his clothes and toothbrush and tied them to a short stick. Softly, he walked through the living room and slipped out into the field. The only light came from one large star. The star gave off a blue-white light so Oscar could see where he was going. He was scared because he was leaving home. He was so cold and lonely, he almost went back. But then he thought of the straw. He said to himself, "I'm going to find some nice straw for a big bed." And with that, he set off. Oscar walked and walked and walked. And he got colder and colder. He came to the top of a hill, and he could see sheep and some shepherds. They had built a little fire to warm themselves. Across from Oscar was another hill. On the side of the hill was a cave. Someone had built a stable in the cave. Oscar could see some animals. He was shivering from the cold. He said, "Well, maybe I can spend the night there. At least I could get out of the wind and cold."
To lay before the king. ox and lamb kept time. Pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. I played my drums for him. Pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. I played my best for
Oscar started climbing up the gray stones to get to the stable. Huffing and puffing, he came up to a rock where he could get a good look at the stable. The cave went back about 10 feet. The wind had eaten the rock out in a half circle. It wasn't very high. The tallest part was only about 6 feet. A 4-foot wall made of medium-sized stones was all around it. A wooden gate, put together by a rope, kept the animals in. Wooden stalls inside kept the wind out. A cow, a few sheep, and two donkeys were the only animals Oscar could see. Oscar walked up the hill to try to get in. The spaces were too small for him to fit through. He peeked in through a space, but much to the light, there was straw all over the floor. He ran to the front gate and pushed against one of the doors. The door slowly moved and then stopped. The latchway up high stopped the door. Too high for me to reach, thought Oscar. He tried again and cracked. A crack appeared between the doors. Too small for a cow or a sheep or a donkey, but just right for a mouse. Quick as a wink, Oscar slipped between the gates. The stable was much bigger than it looked from the outside. Oscar stood at the door, feeling warm for the first time since he ran away from home. He kept looking at the heaps and piles of straw. Oh, wow, he said, and ran around picking up the straw. Suddenly, a huge shadow with horns covered him, and a voice boomed. What do you think you're doing with that straw? Oscar was very scared. He slowly turned around at the huge form, which had him trapped. I was just picking up some straw, he stammered. Who told you you could touch our straw? Demanded the voice. In a teeny little Oscar voice, he squeaked, no one. What did you say? Thundered the voice. No one, sir, repeated Oscar, very frightened by now. It's not sir. My name is Martha. What's your name? Oscar, he replied. Oscar, We don't have any mice in the stable, but as the head cow, I might let you stay. What can you do for us, Oscar? Do? Well, I never thought of that, replied Oscar. Well, you can't stay if you can't do anything. We have no room for a lazy mouse, said Martha. Wait, cried Oscar. I'm small. I can pick up things you drop or lose. I can crawl into tiny spaces for you. Please let me stay. Martha struck the ground with her brown hoof. Well, we'll give you a try. You can stay. The brown and white cow turned away. Oscar called after her. Martha, may I please have some straw? I'll put it into the corner and make a bed for myself. Martha stopped and looked over her shoulder. Just a little bit for my pile. If you want more, you'll have to ask the other animals. Thank you, Martha, said Oscar. You're a real friend. Friend? I'm not your friend, little mouse, yelled Martha as she turned her huge body back to Oscar. Frightened, he dropped the straw. I thought you were my friend because you let me stay and said I could have the straw. The words poured out because Oscar was afraid that Martha was angry with him. Ha, 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 said Martha. Friend? That's a joke. Cows can't be friends with mice. I am a very important cow. You are a little mouse. My friends are only other cows. You're silly, little Oscar, to expect a cow of my importance to be friends with a mouse. With that, Martha gave a snort and in a very dignified way, turned and waddled back to her stall. Oscar was hurt. He wondered why mice and cows couldn't be friends. He picked up a piece or two of straw and walked to the back of the cave. He put the straw into a little pile and started to look for some more. Oscar was talking to himself. I wonder why we couldn't be friends. Friends? A voice said. Why, sure we can be friends. Oscar jumped. Who are you? My name's Henry. My friends call me Hank. You can call me Hank. What's your problem, little mouse? Well, I wanted to get out of the cold and get some straw for a bed and be a friend. And Martha said, no. Slow down, little one. Too many words. You want some straw? Here, take some. You want a friend? I'll bring your friend. A wide smile filled Oscar's face.
Jesus, our brother. Carried his mother to Bethlehem town. I said the donkey all shaggy and brown. I said the cow all white and red. I gave him my hay to pillow his head. I said the cow all white and red. I said the sheep with curly horn. I gave the dove from the rafters high. I cooed him to sleep so he would not cry. We cooed him to sleep, my love and I. I said the dove from the rafters high. Thus every beast by some good spell in the stable rude was glad to tell of the gift he gave Emmanuel, the gift he gave Emmanuel, the gift he gave Emmanuel.
about to open his mouth when Hank said, "We can be friends next Tuesday afternoon." "Yep. Tuesday morning, I've got to eat. Tuesday night, I'll said I'd be friends with Jesse." "I can fit you in, Oscar, Tuesday afternoon between lunch and dinner." "Yep." And Hank walked away and started talking to the other sheep. Oscar's big smile had vanished. Tears were filling his eyes. He bent down to pick up some straw. Slowly, so slowly, he carried them to add to his little pile. "A little more and I'll be done," he said to himself. So he got up and peeked into the stall next to Martha's. "Excuse me, may I have some of your straw?" A head with two giant ears opened and two little eyes stared right at him. "Who are you? What do you want from me?" was the angry question. "My name is Oscar, sir. I'm gathering some straw for my bed. I'd like to be your friend." The donkey stomped his foot. "Sydney's the name, Oscar. You can help yourself to the straw." Oscar was surprised at the answer. He said to Sydney, "Your voice doesn't sound friendly, but you're giving the straw to me. Do you want to be my friend?" Sydney turned his head away. Softly, he said, "No." Oscar asked, "Why not?" In a teeny voice, with his head still turned away, Sydney answered, "Well, I want to be your friend. I want to have friends. But if I become your friend, I might accidentally step on you someday. You're so little, and I'm so big. And if I hurt you and we're friends, I would feel bad. But if I don't know you or don't like you, it doesn't matter what happens to you. If you get hurt, I won't feel bad." But Oscar cried out, "What about the good times? We could play together and have fun together." "Well, that only makes it worse," said Sydney. "The more I like you, the more I risk getting hurt. No, friendship is a dangerous business. Take the straw, little Oscar, and go." With that, Sydney felt silent. Oscar took the straw and finished his bed. He crawled into it. It was perfect, much bigger than his bed at home. But he missed his brothers and sisters. He thought of his father and about the fight they had had. He fell asleep thinking about Martha, Hank, and Sydney. He was asleep for a short while when a loud noise woke him up. He opened his eyes and blinked a few times. The stable was flooded with light from the blue-white star. Oscar looked to see the cause of the sound. He saw two people standing at the gate. One was helping the other walk. The smaller one, a woman, came in a few steps and laid down next to the rocky wall. She held her stomach. Her stomach was very big and stuck out. Every minute or two, her whole stomach would move. The lady would moan softly. She said something to the man, who quickly left.
Silent night.
Slowly crept over to the woman. "Wake!" she screamed. "Oh, don't be frightened," said Oscar. "What's your name?" "My name is Mary," replied the lady. "And yours, little brown mouse?"
"My name is Oscar. I'm looking for a friend."
"Tell me, little Oscar, have you found a friend?"
"Well, first I met Martha. I couldn't be her friend because I wasn't important enough. She wanted me to be someone I'm not and could never be. She turned me down. She didn't want to be my friend."
"There, there now," Mary said in a soft voice. "That's Martha for you. A good friend leaves you free. He lets you be the best person you can be. There's no strings to real friendship. A friend is a mirror of yourself. He lets you see yourself as you are. He lets you be who you are right now."
"Well, it all sounds so simple," Oscar squeaked.
"Oh, I'll tell you a secret," said Mary. "A friend gives you the power to become the best person you can be. You have the choice because a good friend gives you the freedom with this power."
"This power," Oscar asked, "does it have anything to do with what Hank said? He told me he could be my friend on Tuesday afternoon. Can you turn this power on and off?"
"Oh, no, no, no." There was a small smile on Mary's face. "Once you say to someone, I'll be your friend, then that person is special to you. A real friend isn't there only on Tuesday afternoons or until you become someone else. A friend is always there."
"Well, I wanted to be Sydney's friend, but he said no. He told me he didn't want to get hurt."
"He's right, Oscar. To be a friend, you have to leave yourself wide open. That's so the love in your heart can reach out to your friend, and the love in your friend's heart can touch yours."
"Oh, you could reach in and hurt your friend?" said Oscar with eyes open with wonder.
"Yes, Oscar, but that's the secret. The power of friendship is the risk you're taking with a friend.
You're willing to be hurt so that your friend can be whoever he or she wants to be. That's where the power comes from. With that, Mary's stomach started to rise and fall, and she grew short of breath. My baby's coming. My baby boy is going to be born. Eager to help, Oscar asked, can I do anything? Why, yes, my little friend. We have no bed to put the baby in. We will have to use the crib which holds the animal's food. Can you find me some straw so that my baby can sleep comfortably? Oscar lowered his eyes. He wanted to help the lady, but he wanted the cozy straw bed too. He thought about what she had said about friends. Then he looked right at her. I know where there's some straw. I'll be right back. Off he ran. He picked up all the straw on his bed and carried it to the manger. When the man returned, the manger was filled with straw. Oscar felt very good inside. The lady had given him the power to give away his straw. His straw, the one thing that he wanted more than anything else in the whole wide world. He gave it away. He was beginning to learn what Sydney meant about friendship hurting. Somehow, it didn't seem to matter. Joy was bubbling over inside of him. She had touched his heart in every part of him. Oscar didn't understand how he could give part of himself away and have more. But that's what happened. The cry of a newborn baby broke his thinking. He saw a little boy all healthy. The man wrapped him up in a big white blanket and laid him in the manger. The baby rested softly on the straw. Oscar thought of his own family. Perhaps my father was right. I shall wait until the springtime to have my straw. And with that, he left the stable. His heart was light and his feet seemed to fly over the ground. The sun had just started to come up when Oscar got home. He came in and climbed into his bed. He had just closed his eyes when his father's voice woke him. Come on, Oscar, wake up, wake up. We have a big day ahead. Come on, sleepyhead. Why, you'd think you'd been up all night instead of asleep in your bed. Okay, Dad, I'm coming, said Oscar. And as he got out of bed, he realized he was smiling.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive a king. Let every heart prepare.
the end.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh, o'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtails ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
A day or two ago, I thought I'd take a ride, and soon Miss Fanny Bright was seated by my side. The horse was lean and lank, misfortune seemed his lot. He got into a drifted bank, and then we got upsot.
Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Now the ground is white, so go it while you're young. Take the girls tonight and sing this sleighing song. Just get a bobtailed nag, 240 for his speed. Then hitch him to an open sleigh and crack, you'll take the lead.
Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle.